spoke about the major tools being used for industrial engineers like finance and economic tools वगैरह, and then the techniques used by an industrial engineer, method study, time study, work study, motion study, ergonomic study, all that.
Okay. So we started. It was not a big task. Like we started with what is engineering, what a mechanical engineering do. Then what are the different techniques available in industrial engineering, and what is our prime objective? And in this class, like we'll discuss more about like how what are the still people are joining. Okay, if someone is joining, ask them to wait for some time. If someone else is joining after 5-10 minutes, we can allow them all together. Right. In this particular session, I'll just try to give out like a brief about what are the techniques, what we saw in broader. Like we'll still try to narrow down what will be the exact thing. Like if you think about facility layout, like what is your particular part in it, or if it is going to be logistic, what is the particular part of industrial engineering and supply chain management? If it is going to be finance, what is the particular part of the industrial engineer in particular task as well? I didn't record. So in this session, we'll just try to understand what actually an industrial engineer do, because these things will be something very relevant. Like everything will be a continuous process, and whatever you think of writing, you just want to segregate what are the small steps which is getting segregated in most of the places. So if you think about how to confine or how to define or how to separate a mechanical engineer from an industrial engineer, is mechanical engineer will be starting with design and ending with finished goods. But as an industrial engineer, industrial engineer start with raw material and end with end user. Of course, again the cycle continues, because there will be something more called as feedback mechanism, through which you will again go for some reverse. So now you could clearly understand manufacturing is a part of industrial engineering, where you have a production process as well to complete the complete cycle of your manufacturing sequence. So earlier we were discussing, I mean, we have discussed in depth about like what are the different things what we'll be doing. Again, I'll just put it further to make you more clarify how industrial engineer can also act as mechanical engineer. But vice versa is not possible. But still, country like India, we don't have any other option. So all the industrial engineering jobs are grabbed by mechanical engineers by studying courses and doing things. So that's what we are trying to do right now. So we are trying to grab the complete job opportunities of industrial engineering, industrial engineers, by learning what are the tools and techniques what they are going to use. It is like adding some salt and pepper to make your engineering more flavored. It's like you are going to add something on management, something on finance, and something on supply chain. With your mechanical, you are trying to add all these flavors to project yourself as an industrial engineer, which is going to give you more opportunity, right? So the basic things, what I'm speaking about world standard, not about Indian standard. What the industrial engineer does is like they also get try to occupy this mechanical engineering job because like it is from design to production. So of course, industrial engineers should have some basic knowledge about how the design sequence is being formed or how the production process is happening. So first and foremost things comes here is the major responsibilities. Responsibilities of industrial engineers will be project management. So if you think about project management, all particular sequence, whatever you think, like how it is going to be scheduled sequence, everything comes into picture. So, and again, it's again a broad classification. You cannot a project manager will have again 10 different engineers who are working under them. So then comes manufacturing and distribution. We have one more terminology called as production. On upcoming classes, I'll differentiate what is difference between production and manufacturing. To in a broad term, like if you're differentiating manufacturing and production, manufacturing engineers don't think about what is the cost, how the material is reaching. They are more concerned about how a product has to be brought from design to finished good. But production, when it comes into picture, you will have a lot of headaches. Like you should know what is the stock inventory, all those things. Like from raw material purchase till delivery, you have to think about all the sequence. So that makes the difference that comes with your logistic and supply chain as well distribution. Then other thing is the major part is supply chain. Again, in supply chain, going to be the major component in your price tag. Because only depend on this, all your price is going to vary with sequence. Then we were studying something about quality measurement and improvement. In these things, what we'll do is we have QA, quality assurance, and quality control engineers, where again you have to study some courses. Like if you're going to be in building inspection, you have to study some courses on non-destructive testing. If you're going to be in a manufacturing process, you should be learning some courses on machine vision. So with this, they will qualify as QA by QC engineer. Again, we have some other process as well. Then, program management. What is the difference between project management and program management? Can you give a try on it? Like, what do you think? Like, how it will be? What is the difference between a program management or a project management? How it actually differs? Can you guess out anything on that?
So program management actually I think means schedule management, means the scheduling of the different things.
That's what is that thing what you're trying to convey here? What is that thing? That is what my question
Program
is.
management to bring the different people together to do specific type of work, like I think that it comes under the program management.
Yeah, that's what. Specific work, like you are saying everywhere in broad term, no? I just want the specific term for that. How do you fill that particular word
So
with
means
the
offshore work. So means offshore work.
offshore? What is that? That's what.
For example, we have to make any product using the manufacturing technology. So there are group
Okay.
of people are working there. So what we will do, we will assign the different works to the different people. Suppose one people will do this type of work, some people will do other type of work. So we are scheduling the different types of works to the different people. I think that it
Then
comes under the program management.
what is project management?
So project management total, so overall work done by the different people, then scheduling their works, how much each people is doing the different types of work, and then
now you keep on together. Saying something, na? That's what I just want to bring a clarity on that thought. Something or some work, some process.
Project management will be like you give an assignment and we complete and give it back to you. You are okay. The project manager over there. But if you are conducting the whole semester, and that way you are the program manager.
Cool. Now we are getting in par. Like, now can you just elaborate? Like, how you can you dig deep? Like, what is that? Now we have got some idea. Project management is a sequence of operation where one particular task is carried out. That is project management. You have the project manager. Now when it comes to a program, like, you will have a set of projects running under
you are like a company.
So now sorry, can you differentiate what is project management and program management now with your basic understanding? Now can you try to interlink with some process?
Sir, I think that program will be included in the project management. It is a part of the project management.
No, that's what it is the other way around. Where you have a project and a complete program. That's why I just want to bring a clarity over here.
Like, so BTech is a program that we are working under NIT Srinagar, while as project is a particular semester or particular subject
course what you are taking, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So now you got that clarity. Now I just want to think in a industrial aspect how this actually defines. Can you just bring out some input on that particular thing, particular task?
So for example, we have to make the car. We are working in an industry and we have to make the car. Suppose, sir, to make the car, sir, we have to do a lot of processes. Sir, then it will be included in the program. Sir, for example, we have to do the particular projects. For example, sheet metal operation, manufacturing process, and all that, sir, it will be included in the program management.
No, again, you're confusing. That's why I need a clarity.
Like, I am having a company which builds ship.
Okay.
If I'm getting an opportunity from Evergreen, I will build a ship for them and give it to them. That is a project.
Okay.
And the project is done by you if you are the manager.
Okay.
The whole company as a whole, the financing, the deals that are coming and going out in the future and or in the past are managed by you, then you are the program manager.
Again, you are there. That's what I just want to confine your things. Again, you think like, don't you think this finance will comes in project management?
For a particular project, it will, but not
That's the whole clarity. What I want to bring it over here. What is the difference
between?
You are
looking for a word. I am not getting that word.
That's what. That's why I'm trying hard. Like, how do you get things? You have some idea, but I just want to make it more clear. What is a program and what is a project? That's it. Any other cases? No. Whatever you told, everything is right. Whatever you both told, everything is right in an aspect. But when it comes to a project, you told a shipbuilding company, right? You are getting one from Evergreen and one from Indian Navy, right? So if you are, the complete process about this is a project management. But at the end, the complete process of manufacturing in your industry, this everything you have to take care of, like what is the scheduling, sequencing, budgeting, supply chain, everything for this, the project manager will be taken care. For this, a separate project manager will be taken care. But all this come into admin, where apart from this, you may have to have meeting with the clients, update the progress, and if needed, they will come for inspection. So you have to cite to the project manager that so-and-so people are coming in this particular things. So you have to know all that. This is what the hierarchy is. So you will be handling all other aspects, again, you'll have a particular team, like there will be a lot of people working under you to know things, but you will be handling both. Like as a program manager, you will be having the complete sort out what is actually happening. Suppose if your company is not only shipbuilding, they do something on, say, like even in shipbuilding, we'll differentiate like
sheet metal.
Yeah, sheet metal. Without sheet metal operation, we cannot go for shipbuilding.
Fishery.
Wait. No, yeah. If you are going to be a coastal line, again in shipbuilding,
engine design.
You have different aspects. Like one is cargo ship, and one is passenger ship. So you'll be doing too many projects on passenger ship, and you'll be doing too many projects on cargo ships. So this program manager will be assigned only for one particular program, either it is passenger ship or cargo ship. Again, on this hierarchy, there comes your decision making, like maybe your director or MD. That's why they call them as program director, not project director. Right. This is program manager will be there. Over them all, there will be a program director. And then comes your CEO or managing director of your company. So this is how this hierarchy actually works. So it's a cluster of events. Like when you have in a small company, you don't have all this aggression. But when you go to MNC, like you may have to know all this stuff, because your position will be somewhere starting at this level.
Sir, but if our project is very small, so then how can we distinguish the program manager and the project manager?
That's what I was saying, na. If you are working in a small company, these are
it
not applicable.
Very small.
It is very small in the sense, now like...
Sir, small means we have to do only one type of job. So for example, if it will be so, sir, then how can we distinguish the program and the project?
Yeah. Now I'll say what is that. Zarga is running a company, owner of the company, only employee of the company, marketing executive of the company, maintenance engineer of the company, project engineer of the company, program manager of the company. So if we are working on a small concern, one person, like this is how entrepreneurship works.
Yes sir. I got it.
Works in a way.
Sir, I got it.
So that is the difference between when you go on a bigger sin and when you confine yourself in a smaller thing. As work increases, you need a lot of people. That's how it goes. Okay. Then comes ergonomics and human factor. This I was saying from the beginning, ergonomics and human factor. How do you think like this will be having maximum impact as an industrial engineer? Ergonomics and human factor.
Sir, please can you repeat this factor again, sir, what you have written?
Ergonomics and human factors.
So you yourself gave an example previously about your boss who used to take you to cinema. You were happy with that person even though you are getting less pay.
That is a part of what you say. That one comes with your ergonomics or human factors. That is something different. I was explaining on the context of profit making. How to please your workers.
Sir, human factors, I think that, sir, for example, we are giving more number of jobs to the particular person. Sir, then this way, sir, one person will get more number of jobs and another will get less person of the job. So it will be the imbalance between the two persons. So that is, I think, the human factor.
Any other guesses? Because everything is a guess here. Any other guesses? What do you think about ergonomics or human factors?
Both the common culture misses the time of in the construction.
Sorry?
So more will be the, if human factor is like more in numbers, then if you are constructing anything, then it will take less time.
No. Till now, whatever you have told is
skills that different people have.
Sorry?
So skills that different people have. For example, some person will have more skill and some will have less skill.
No. Then?
So like the healthier the person is, he will be able to work for longer hours.
No. Then?
For a safer environment for the workers.
Sorry?
So safety for the workers, the environment.
Environment. This word I'll take. Safety also can be included. Now we are closing to the part. So safety and environment. These are, you can get clubbed also, safety, environment, or this can be a part of economics. Now you think on this way. This is about environment concern and safety concern. So now think more on it. What would be ergonomics or human factors?
Sir, arrangement of machines and all these things in proper way, that it can not harm the people and workers.
Okay. It will not harm the people. Okay. Then you have arranged everything, because these are the things which is basic need of a company. After that, still you have to dig in deep to understand what is ergonomics or human factor engineering.
Sir, can we include the human insurance, sir, health insurance in it? Sir, health insurance.
That's all basic part. Like I'm just confining towards this word ergonomics. What is ergonomics or human factors engineering? So whatever you said is something relevant. It's not irrelevant to the company. Whatever you said, these are the basic things. Apart from that, people have some requirement on ergonomics and human factors. There is a huge research going on this particular topic. Can you guess, make any more guesses, or let me give an intro of it?
Sir, no idea.
Anyone want to make a guess?
Sir, the amount of work a certain person can do and the amount of burden that a company should put on certain person.
Exactly. Now we are coming close. Stress bearability. Yeah, amount of work certain person can do, or yeah, this is also something in the loop. Like if you say this as a circle, you people are hitting somewhere over here, somewhere over here. But ergonomics stands here.
It's important for productivity.
It is important for productivity, yeah. No other go.
Sir, then it will reduce the fatigue and strain of the workers.
Yeah. Something that
design
is going
to... Design workplaces.
Fatigue and strain of a worker. So now this is something close here. Something close here. Fatigue and strain of the worker. So now what is ergonomics? It is going to reduce the fatigue
designing
and strain
of workplaces.
Of the worker. Sorry?
Designing of workplaces.
So exactly. Comfort of workers.
Exactly. Designing of workplaces. And someone was saying something. What is that?
Comfort for workers.
Comfort for workers. So this is what is all about ergonomics is. So ergonomics is something which makes a worker comfort without straining much, doing the work in an effective way. It's like and my job is to carry this and place it. There is a conveyor going, and my job is to take this from here and put it in a tray, which is down. So that time, what my complete body is going to happen is, I have to take one from here and put it down. So my total body will be becoming fatigued over a period of time. You can just think why they are getting money, they can work, but you should be smart enough to get more effectiveness from the work what they are doing. Simple. So the job is to take from here.
Is there any difference between the safety and the ergonomics, or
lot of safety is there. Safety is the basic requirement. Ergonomics is to improve the efficiency. Safety is not to improve the efficiency. Safety is the basic requirement what your company is needed. Ergonomics is something what you implement on the company, on the workers, on the product or facility layout, on the design sequence to improve the efficiency. So safety and ergonomics are completely two different things. Safety is the prior most thing, and ergonomics is something again like an ingredient you are adding to your company to improve the efficiency. So this is completely different, right?
Okay.
Let me continue with my example. So this is objective. My job in the company is to take this component, finish it, and put it in a tray. That is the only job. But what is this ergonomic stasis? So if I'm doing that, after 10 minutes, say, I'm collecting around 50 components, then I'll feel back pain or hand pain, this, that. My 5 minutes will go waste. So how to make you utilize that 5 minutes also without any fatigue? Because if you are falling ill, you are getting back pain or neck pain, whatever it is. If you are sitting on a particular system, if you are facing it, so over a period of time, you will have some strain happening to your body, which is going to impact directly impact on the work what you are doing. So the ergonomics or human factor engineering makes the human life more comfortable for the work. So what they will do is, this is the tray, and one more thing will be here. So I just want to take it here and place it here. Take it here and place it here. It is, if I'm taking here and dropping it here, it will take 5 seconds. But if I'm taking it here and putting it here, it will take only 1 or 2 seconds. My work rate will increase. At the same time, my body will not get strained because I'm not putting more work. I am just putting work for my hands, not my entire body. Same way, each and everything, whatever you see, whatever the system you are sitting on, based on your ergonomics design, people used to say like, it should be somewhere like over your chest. You should not, that's why people say like, you should not work like this in laptop for over a period of time. Your spine will get down and you will get neck pain, all those stuff. So what you have to do is you have to sit straight and put your system right. And it should be somewhere like your forehead should be directly matching to the top of the screen, so that like you are not going to bend or do something like that. So this chair again, if you see different design, it will be something bend like this or flat like this. And if you see this particular thing, they have given this flexibility so that like whatever your body is resting, it will get adapted to that. Like there will be a bend obviously in that, and this push over here, this push, whatever, I think you could see what is happening here, right?
Yes, sir.
This projection over here, where here it is flat and here it is coming. So your backbone will actually land over here so that it will not bend. Your backbone will be kept at straight, and this again, you are not putting it forward. So you are going to relax something over here. And that is why this is again kept in such a way. You are putting over here and sitting. So your working posture will be something like this. In that condition, your screen should be somewhere above. And these factors are not just like what we are speaking right now. There are a lot of research taking around 50 workers in a software company, putting them in different design sequence and testing them, how their work is, how their efficiency is. How it again depends on people performance also, but that is completely neglected over here. They are considering everyone are equally efficient, everyone are assigned for the particular work and they are completing it on a same efficiency. So that is the significance considered in that. And what is the different aspect comparing? Like, okay, you are not putting your laptop you are not putting your body like this and typing your in your keyboard. So what I'm doing here is I'm having like this. So I just want to see here like this. After some time, I have to sit like this and write it. So over a period of time, I may get some pain somewhere. I will be getting mean. There will be some fatigue generated in my body, and there will be some strain generated in my body that will make me quite uncomfortable, and I lost my face. So in order to avoid all this discomfort that is happening to your body, your work environment, either the machine you are handling or tool you are going to operate or machine you are going to operate or the sitting posture or the working place, everything is designed based on ergonomics design. So all this are designed in an ergonomical way. It is nothing for a nothing but the comfort of a worker or an employee or a a person who is working on a particular process. You are making him quite comfortable to work continuously without any deficiency in his performance due to the environment or the working nature. That's why if you could see, like, if you see in IT companies, people will be there and everyone will have a cubicles. It is again a part of ergonomics design to avoid distraction. If it is like whatever you have for your horse, right? So you are focused more, you are not getting to see here or there. So all this comes under ergonomics design in order to improve the efficiency of the employee. Because of course, like if it is flat, it is also simple design. You don't have any problem. But if you see most of the IT companies, everything will be cubicle design. Only reason is if you turn around like this, hi, how are you? How are things going? Then that chat continue for next 20 minutes where your performance, whatever doing here, will be completely lost. To avoid all those, they will have something like this. So you don't have any other option. Only thing is you have to work like this and you keep on concentrating things. And that is why most of the companies, they don't allow cell phone inside. They don't have, like, they have most of the Facebook banned, this most of the web pages banned, or no games, or like games are being uninstalled. So all this is done as a part of ergonomics design to improve the efficiency. So ergonomics is something which is comforting the employee to improve the efficiency of the process, whatever he is doing. Either it can be based on the design or sitting arrangement, or it can be based on a layout, or it can be environment or the surrounding which is going to disturb the focus or the process in which he is going to, he is carrying out to complete a particular task. So that is what all about ergonomics is. And human factor engineering is, ergonomics deals with all this, and human factor engineering is, this deals completely about the comfort zone of a human. Like if you sit like this for a period of time, you will not feel back pain. But if you think about the chairs, what we have, plastic chairs in here, it will be complete, I mean, something like this. But now if you see the new chairs, there will be a small projection like this, even in new plastic chairs, based on the ergonomics design. If you see an ice cream parlor or hotels, like where you have a flat, small chair, which is completely bent like this, and you won't find this landing if you are going to use that for a purpose of maybe around half an hour or 1 hour. You will not have something like this. You will have only till this portion, and the reason is you are not going to sit there. If you are going to hotel or any public places, you are not going to sit there for more than 20 or 30 minutes or hardly 1 hour. So that is designed accordingly in order to reduce the cost as well as make it more effective during the process. You are feeling comfortable on sitting at that particular time for a particular duration of time. You will find only chairs like this if you are going to sit there over a period of time. Like if you are going to, your job is only to sit there and work, that time you may need some concentration, because like you have, again, you'll get neck pain or something like this. So you have to focus more on this. This is how the human factor engineering works. Again, it is going to be either the strain what you are doing, the layout what you are happening, and how the arranging of your machineries. If it is going to be assembly part, you have one over here, one over here, one over here, one over here. And if you see in assembly line, there will be something running over their forehead like this. there will be some components over here, they'll be doing assembly over here, they'll be picking and doing assembly. They will not like go take something from there, they'll go some take something from there and do the assembly. Everything will be arranged in a sequence so that they are feeling quite comfort and doing the work like this and fitting it and running off, so that they are strained less, their efficiencies mean production is also increased, efficiency also is increased. At the same time, they are not strained much. Again, next day they can repeat the same task without any fitting. Right. This is what is all about human factor engineering. Now you are getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next comes is strategic planning. Any idea about what strategic planning is?
Goal or destination?
Goal. Yeah. Goal or destination? When it is short term or long term?
Sorry, it will depend upon the project.
Exactly. This is what all I recommend. Depends. It can be short term as well as long term. So where short term can be used or long term can be used?
Sir, short term can be used. For example, we have to manufacture the pen. Sir, it can be short term. Sir, okay. And to make the, for example, ship and aeroplane. Sir, it can be long term.
Ship and aeroplane. Not exactly. Again, when you go to a big company, this also comes under.
So, but it will take a lot of time to manufacture the car, to make the pen.
Now here, that's why I just want to give a clarity. Short term and long term is, short term is like mission, what you have at the end of the course. Long term is vision at the after graduation, how you will become. So short term, everything comes at like if you are going to complete a course, it is also a short term goal. If you are going to complete your degree, it is also short term course because you have something beyond that. After that, you have some sequence. But long term is your final destination, what you have planned. Say suppose like someone here in your class, someone like I should not always take Zergar name, I'll take someone else name. Who is ready? Okay, someone in your class want to be in politics. So his or her short-term goal will be completing BE, but long-term goal will be politics. So for short-term strategy, they have to study, they have to complete the courses, they have to complete the credit and complete your degree. That is the strategy what you have to follow for completing the course. But long-term for getting into politics, they should know how to interact with people and they should have influence, or they should be more famous among the society. And what are the strategies to be done for all this over a period of time to get into this particular destination? Again, after this you have something, but when we consider about industry or institute, we'll have strategic plan for 5 years. According to our government, what is the strategic plan for this five-year financial planning? What revolution we are in?
Budget.
What revolution we are in? At what era we are in right now? What is the prime focus of next 5 year of our government? Strategic plan for next
make
5 years.
In India.
So that comes under industrial revolution, where it is industry 4.0. So that is the strategy plan for next 5 years to convert everything into make in India. For that, they are doing too many strategy planning. They are focusing more on industry. They are focusing more on startups. They are right now, even I was saying something about that in our class, no? For toy manufacturing, something they are funding more for toy manufacturing, because almost 90 to 95% of the toys are imported from China.
Okay.
From China. We don't have any plan. Right now, in past 2 years, One is in Noida and one is in Hyderabad. So these two places, toy manufacturing unit have been implemented. So now government is ready to fund almost 70% at free of cost if some startup is ready to invest 30% for toy manufacturing. Even if it is 5 crore or 10 crore, they are ready to fund you. Only you have to invest 30%. If anyone has an idea of making some own enterprises, you have some amount with you. If it is going to be 10 lakh, you have to invest 3 lakh. Government will fund you 7 lakh. If it is going to be 10 crore, you have to invest 3 crore. Government will fund you 7 crore. So this much funding opportunity government is giving on this 5-year strategic plan. That's why most of the budget is on this. So this is about strategic plan. What you have, either it's a short or long-term goal. What is the objective? What you are going to have on prime focus? So in company aspect, if you think of whatever you say, the strategy plan, the short-term goal is strategy plan for making a pen or a ship or aeroplane. But this is short-term strategic plan. What are the strategies to be followed? When it comes to long-term strategic plan, what are the different varieties of pen you are going to make? How you are going to optimize it and improve it? What are the different, again, when it comes to ship, like right now you will be making one particular ship. How to improvise it? How to become pioneer in that? So that will be the long-term strategic plan when you think about strategic plan. Any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay, finally, I'll just wind up with this. Final part is financial engineering. So again, this everyone must be aware, because everything you need a proper plan for financing, and there again you have direct cost and indirect cost, where direct cost comes with man, material, and indirect cost comes with maintenance, holding cost. Even indirect, like logistics, also comes in direct mostly, but it can be good. Holding, maintenance, holding cost, even logistics, you can put in indirect cost. And these are variable all the time. This will have the maximum impact on your thing, because this will be mostly stagnant. Your material and manpower, the charge is not going to vary over a period of time, right? Very few, unless until you are in a petroleum company, the material cost will not vary every day. But indirect cost, this has a lot of influencing factor that drives your productivity. Productivity is majorly affected by these different cost which is happening. So as a financial engineer, it's not like I have not studied finance, I cannot lie. Again, there will be an industrial engineer who will be acting as a finance engineer as well. So in that condition, you have to look care of all these things.
Sure.
So yeah.
So what is holding cost?
Sorry?
What is holding cost, sir?
Holding cost, warehouse. You will have a warehouse to deposit your material at some point. Suppose I'll put an example of Amazon. Amazon, every city has a warehouse, right? So for putting your material over there, you have to have invest on man, space, again maintenance. All this comes under holding cost. So that's what everything we'll explain in detail. The first unit is completely about introduction to complete industrial engineering. So when you study further on industrial engineering, you're again going to study the same thing in a deeper way, like how we are segregating each and everything, right? So with this, I'll wind up the session for the day. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. And Monday, we are organizing one workshop for 1 week. Like Monday, I'm inviting you all to be part of it. The inauguration starts by 9:30 in the presence of director, and chief guest will be PM Pandey sir from IIT Delhi.
Well, but what will be the topic? Sir, what will be the topic?
Additive manufacturing. I'll just share you the poster. 1 minute. In your WhatsApp group, I'll just share the poster. I don't think you may have the provision to register because it is one.